Hello guys, have a very good evening. So it's time 7:30 p.m. and we are going to start right now. Okay, so I guess all the beginners are here right now. Okay, so kind request to everyone, please don't spam in the messages. Okay, if you have any questions or any doubt, so we can have a 15 minutes of session. That will be started around 8:30 or 8:45 to 9 p.m. Okay, so if you have any questions, and you can ask me at that time. But till now, please stop spamming the chat box. Okay, so I will share my screen with you. Okay, hope you are watching my screen. Okay, let's start with the basic. Okay, ethical hacking, cyber security, and bug bounty program. So this session is all about this by SecRB, and my name is Mitesh Bhatia. Okay, so this is a legal disclaimer. Every time when we go for a movie, we watch a disclaimer, right? Like all the contents in this movie are for this, that. Okay, but in this I had added one more word, legal. Okay, so legal means all the things that I'm going to teach you today, that will be only for the study purpose. If you use it for any other purpose, that will, I will not be responsible for that thing. Okay, so use it for wisely, especially for the security purpose, not for any illegal purpose. Okay, so let me start with who am I. Okay, my name is Nitesh Bhatia. I'm a security researcher and a certified ethical hacker, public speaker. I give workshops, conferences, national, international level, and also a member of National Information Security Council and the manager of National Cyber Security Conference, Interscot Cyber Intelligence Trainer. And also I give training to police, CID, and BSF people. Okay, so let's start with hacking. Okay, might be some of you know about what is hacking. Okay, so you can see here password, spam, email, attack. Okay, most of the hacking elements we use like this. Okay, hacking into someone's system. Hacking, the term hacking means illegal access to someone's system, someone's database, someone's website, or anything without the permission of the administrator. Okay, means we will enter into the database, we will check the database without, but the administration means the admin. For example, you are having the access of my system, but I had not given any permission to you. Okay, so that is an illegal thing. Okay, but right now we are here for the security, cyber security and ethical hacking. Okay, ethical hacking, ethical means in a working in a legal way. Okay, so what we're gonna do here, we will talk about the security things. Okay, might be some of the people here, hackers like this, WinRAR. I'm using it still for free, I'm a hacker. Okay, but the thing is, why WinRAR is giving you free access to this software? There is a reason behind this. For example, many of you, for example, are here gamers. Okay, when we install any game, every time it will ask for the license key, but most of us, we use crack versions, right? In the crack versions, what is that? Why, if, for example, if I am running a software company, you want to access my software, but you don't want to pay that. Okay, then what will you do? Most of the people look for the crack version. Okay, who is, for example, I'm giving any of you random person, okay, is giving a antivirus that costs around $100 per month. Okay, and he's getting around 100 users per month, so that will be around 100 × 100, $10,000 USD per month. Okay, but I also want to access that software, but I don't want to pay you. Okay, so in that case, what will I do? I will crack that software and use it for mine purpose. Okay, so what will the loss of the company? That only 100 users. Okay, but the thing is, I also uploaded it to the internet, so other people can also use that. Okay, So what is my profit in that? The question is this. Okay, so in that case, what will I do? I will also install a virus file. I will attach that virus file in the software in which you are going to access. Okay, so whenever you install my software, my virus that is behind the software that you are using automatically get installed in your system. So what can I do? I can use your system remotely. Okay, I can access the power of your system. Sometimes you have seen that you are not using anything, but in the task manager you can see your disk space is around 100% full. Okay, why is that? Because might be 90% there are chances that someone else is using your system power. Okay, so there are chances like that. So if you can check, open your task manager and you can see that what is the disk space, how much disk space space is covered. Okay, this process is called botnet. Okay, botnet is derived from two words, bot plus net. Okay, bot means robot and net means network. Means so botnet means network of robots. Means it works like a robot. Let someone else is using your system as a robot. He is accessing the power of your system. He is accessing disk space. This is I can also attack from my system, from your system to any other website using this thing. Okay, it will be like that is also called remote code execution, RCE, that we call. Okay, so if someone wants to catch me, that will come to you first. Okay, there are some hackers group, Anonymous, that is the biggest one you can say. Okay, so let's talk about the hacks, means how many types of hackers are there. Okay, first one is black, second gray, and third one is white. Okay, black hat hackers are who do completely illegal things. Okay, like credit card frauds. Okay, hacking into a website and delete the database, leak the database. Okay, they work like that. Means simply in a they work like in a illegal way. Okay, second one we call that white hat hackers. White hat hackers are also known as penetration tester. Okay, the work of white hat hackers and the penetration testers are to calculate the risk space. Okay, means they will calculate at which point your security is going to breach. Okay, security breach means at which point the security is lack using the loopholes, and they will find the loopholes and make a list. Okay, what are the loopholes, and they will also add the process, which tools they are using. Okay, what are the results of those tools, which type of vulnerabilities are there. Okay, and something like, and they will also create a report. The first step is of footprinting, then scanning, then gaining access, then maintaining access, then clearing the tracks. Okay, they will give a complete report to the administrator. Okay, it means in this case everything will be in legal way. Okay, legal way means the administration give the permission to the tester, that is called a white hat hacker or a penetration tester. They will check the security and they will check, identify the vulnerabilities and report to the administration panel. Okay, so what they will do, they will provide the security. Okay, then next one is gray hat hacker. What gray hat hacker will do? They will do both the things, illegal as well as legal. Okay, it means that for example, I'm an Indian person, Indian. What will I do? I will attack on some other countries, like the most of the favorite one, Pakistan. Okay, I will attack into Pakistan websites. I will leak the database. I will delete the database. But when it comes to my country, that is India, what will I do? I will give the security. Okay, I will provide, I will test the security. What are the security loopholes? What are the vulnerabilities? And I will try to fix it. I will make a report and then I will send it to the admin. And then it will goes to the developer part and they will check and provide the increase the security. Okay, so the thing is, hacking is legal or illegal. Okay, there are only two options, that are yes and no. Okay. Sorry. Okay, so hacking is legal or legal. Okay, the thing is, there is a very small difference between ethical hacking and hacking. Okay, First one is legal and illegal. Okay, it means if we are going to do attack for a security purpose, then it is called ethical hacking or a penetration testing. But when the things that we are going to do for the illegal purpose, it means to harm someone or to attack someone, that will be for, that is called an illegal purpose. Okay, for example, the thing is you are going to test on my website. Okay, and what will you do? You will find the vulnerability. Firstly, the very first step in the ethical hacking and hacking will be same reconnaissance, footprinting, or information gathering, we can say. Okay, we will gather the information, then we will scan the website, we will find the vulnerabilities and report them. Okay, and then we will attack on the website. It means the vulnerability that we got is exactly working or not. Okay, so that is called a POC, proof of concept. Okay, that I will tell you in further. Okay, so what it will do, in illegal way, we will find the vulnerability and attack on the vulnerability to harm the victim. Okay, we will harm the victim, and what will happen there, the website, for example, you can say when this Pulwama attack was done, some of the Indian hackers hack into the Pakistan government websites. Even we also, okay, we hack into some websites and we put the logo there of Sikh Army and some of abusing language also for Pakistan, and we also write the Jai Hind and Jai Bharat or some words like that. That is called an illegal purpose. Okay, but when it come, but when we call about the security, okay, what will we do? In that case, we will find the vulnerability and report it to the administration, so they can increase the security. Okay, so that is the difference between hacking is illegal or legal. Okay, depends upon the motive, because all the skills of the black hat hacker and white hat hacker will be same. All the tools that they are going to use, that will be same. Okay, it depends upon the mindset. Okay, now the thing is how to make your computer 100% secure. Okay, let's take a 5 to 10 seconds. Think about this thing, how you can make your computer 100% secure. Okay, I'm getting some answers, but I cannot see that right now. Okay. Okay, so the thing is, first option is don't buy a computer. Okay. Second one is, if you bought that, don't ever switch it on. Okay, because the thing is, whatever the security you can give to your system or to the network or to anything, okay, that can be breached. Okay, because, okay, so let's talk about the teams. Okay, so there will be every company, there will be two teams will be there. Okay, blue team and red team. Red team is for attack, that is also called offensive security. And blue team is for defense, because in every company wants to secure their data, but also they want to attack on the other company's database. Okay, so let's talk about something about bug bounty. Okay, bug bounty, we can get this much of amount by bug bounty. Okay, companies receive the vulnerability report that I was talking about. Okay, and vulnerability is a simple security flaw using the loophole we can get enter into the website. Okay, so what bug hunters, bug bounty, a person who will do that bounty, that is called a bug hunter. Okay, what type of rewards for a valid submission? Okay, valid submission means they will get a proper vulnerability. Okay, sorry. They will, if they have a valid submission, means if they have a valid submission, means the vulnerability that they are going to report is already existing, and so that will call in a duplicate POC. Okay, but if the condition, in this condition, if that thing is if the vulnerability is new, okay, to the website or to the network or whatever it may be. So they will give you some bounty. So bounty, it can be come from $10 to $1 lakh. Okay, it depends upon the criticality of the bug. Okay, or otherwise, if the vulnerability is low, so they can give you some swag, some t-shirts, hoodie, mugs. Okay, or else they can give you appreciation certificate. Okay, and the most important thing, they can give you the Hall of Fame. For example, if you find a vulnerability on Facebook and you report that vulnerability that is not existing previously, so they will give you the bounty. It can be $10, it can be $10,000. Okay, so it varies from the criticality of the bug. Okay, for bug bounty platform, you can sign up in HackerOne, BugCrowd, Bug Bounty Factory, Bug Bounty IP, Integrity, and Open Bug Bounty. Okay, so bug bounty platform, most of the people will not have any idea about this thing. Okay, so let me clear you about this thing. Okay, yeah, so yeah, this is the most important thing in bug bounties or bug submission, and also write up of the bug that we have found. Okay. Okay, so it depends upon the how is your submission. Okay, so these are the priorities: P1, P2, P3, P4, P5. Okay, these are the levels, you can say. P5 is the lowest one, that is called informational. In this vulnerability, you can maximum you will get a thank you letter from the website that okay, that you had done the submission, valid submission was there, but that is not a proper. And P4 a low, medium, P3 P2 high, and P1 critical. In case of critical vulnerability in any website, you can get a bounty of around $500 to $10,000. It depends upon the website and also on the vulnerability type. Okay. Now, how the report submission is. Okay, let me tell you the format also. Firstly, the title. Okay, title means what type of attack is going to do on the website. For example, we are trying to do a SQL injection. Okay, SQL injection, we will not write the SQL injection. We will write, the title will be database theft. Okay, or the database leakage. Because in SQL, we know very thing. SQL is a structured query language using for database management. Okay, so what will we do here? We will leak the database. Okay, then description. In description, we can write that which type of SQL injection is working on it. Okay, type of SQL means there are around 16 SQL injection that I know right now. Okay, I don't know how many others will be there. Okay, so the basic thing is, let me tell you something about that also. Authentication bypass. We will bypass the login password. Okay, we can enter into the website without any username or password. Okay, second one will be normal SQL injection, or we can also say that union based SQL injection. Okay, third one will be the string based SQL injection. Mode security is there, 403 forbidden, base 64, time based injections. Okay, this type of injection we can do. Okay, then the third thing is impact. Okay, in impact, what is the impact of the vulnerability? Okay, for suppose we are going to do SQL injection, so what will the impact of that SQL injection? Okay, so means if we do SQL injection, what will happen to the website? We can get the database. Okay, then vulnerability link or product, we have to mention the vulnerability link on which link we were attacking. Okay, environment tested on. Environment means like which browser that we were using, what was the version of that browser, which operating system that you use, what the tools that you are using. Okay, and then POC, proof of concept. Okay, this is the most important thing. Means we have to give the proof that we can't just say that I hacked into your website and I got the database of your system or your device or the website. But we have to mention that we have to give the proof. Okay, then mitigations, how to overcome that thing. Okay, means if the vulnerability is there, then how we can overcome that vulnerability. Okay, then references, which type of references that we can use. Okay, know your scope, who is awesome, you are awesome, because everything depends upon the practice. If you do practice on a single thing and around 10 to 15 times, then you can be perfect. Okay, thumb rule, think out of the box. Okay, report as soon as possible when you find the bug. Okay, and it's a question for the engineering students mostly. Okay, thinking out of the box. Okay, a son is asking to his dad that, dad, why do we need five fingers when there are only two mouse buttons? Okay, the thing is that the son is not asking to the dad that in not in a sarcastic way, but in a logistic way. If we think about this thing, okay, so suppose these are the five fingers. Okay, not suppose, these are. Okay, first thing is why do we need five fingers? Okay, so what will you do? First thing is we need to find the in which way that we are going to do. Okay, mostly there are engineering students. I was just reading in the message in the chat box. Okay, so engineering students, how many engineers will we pass out in a year? Okay, more than 10 lakh. So okay, so is there any job opportunity or job opportunities for those 10 lakh students? Okay, so what will you do then? Okay, there are two options. Mostly we will choose five things. Okay, but I know about computer science student. Okay, because I'm good in computers, so I will tell you about that. The first thing is AI, artificial intelligence. Okay, in artificial intelligence, right now there is no scope in India, but it is emerging day by day. Okay, but maximum you can say 4 to 5 years, everything gonna be at AI. Okay, we have smart homes, we have smart mobiles, we have smart home appliances and all. Okay, and the second thing will be cyber security. In cyber security, a lot of jobs are there, because we know this thing that everything, we can say just simple, everything is going to be digital. From the payments, from our food, we can online do shopping, we can do online food buying. Okay, we can do everything online. So the thing is, where is the security? Okay, we also have to provide a security. The second thing is security, cyber security. That's why it is asking that, why do we need two fingers? Okay, I will not take much time on the theoretical part. I will come to this thing. Who we are? Security researchers. Okay, what we do? We find bugs day and night. Okay, what will we get? Duplicates. Because whenever you find the bug, just report it. Don't wait for that, I will do it tomorrow. Because if someone else find the bug on that, then it will goes to, the bounty will goes to that person. Okay, the tools operating system that we can use, that is operating system that we can use, Kali operating system, Bob suit, browsers, plugins that we can use. Okay, methodology that we can use is OWASP top 10 vulnerability. Okay, if you find a vulnerability of SQL injection or XSS or CSRF, you find any vulnerability, then you can go for the bug bounty. It might be you can get any bounty. Okay, so books and references. Okay, question answer session we will have after some time, after 30 minutes. Okay, or it's 7:53 already. Okay, so after 30 minutes we will have a question answer session. Okay, so if you guys have any questions, okay, you can WhatsApp to this now contact number, or for any other information you can contact to this email ID. Okay, so if anyone of you interested to join the course, then they can contact to this number or email ID. Okay, okay, so now let's move to other thing. Okay. Okay, now let me show you example of SQL injection. Okay, I will try. Remember one thing, I'm just giving a demo class. Okay, so if you try this thing on any other website, I will not be responsible because I'm testing on those website and I'm attacking on those website which are I had already done. Okay. For example, we use some Google Docs. Okay. Before you going to this thing direct to the attack, let me show you something. Okay. The thing is steps of hacking, or you can say phases of hacking. Okay. The first phase of hacking is information gathering. Okay. In information gathering, what will you do? We will find the all the information about the attack in which we are going to attack. Okay. Sorry. We will gather complete information about the in which the person we are going to attack. Okay. The simple thing is, for example, you are going to attack on me. Okay. But the thing is, you don't know anything about me. Then what will you do? Okay. In physically, we can say you will directly come to me and start attacking, right? But in information, but the thing is, if you came to know that I'm good in boxing, okay, then who will got hit? Okay, so in this case, you will not come to come to fight with me if you know that I'm good in boxing. So you will not come directly and start punching or hitting me. Okay. Second phase is scanning. Okay, in scanning, what will we do? We will find the vulnerabilities. Okay. For example, you are attacking on me and you find a vulnerability in me. That is, I afraid of a knife. Okay, I don't afraid, but for example, I afraid of a knife. But and what will you do then? You will come to fight with me with a knife. Okay, so it will be easier to attack on the website. In attack, we can say if you if you find that there is a SQL vulnerability, but you are trying on XSS or CSRF attack or any other attack, so it is just completely a waste of time. Okay, then third step is gaining access. Okay, gaining access means we will attack on the website and we will gain the access on that. Okay. And fourth step will be maintaining access. Maintaining access means, for example, someone you attacked on the website and they increase the security and they change the password also. Okay, what will you do in that case? Okay, in that case, if we will again, we have to follow these steps. We again have to find the information. We again have to find the vulnerability. Okay, and we again have to find the vulnerability and we again have to attack. But in this case, maintaining access, what will we do? Okay. We will just attack on the website. Okay. And we will upload a shell. Okay. Shell is a PHP coding. Okay. In that, what we'll do, we'll replace any file with our shell. And if you want to access on that thing, okay. So what will it do? It will just directly drop you to the control panel of the website. Okay. So in that case, we just don't need to attack on the website again and again. It will just directly attack on the website. We can get directly enter into the website using this thing. Okay. And the fifth one is clearing tracks. Okay. Clearing tracks means we will clear all the logs that we will use in this. For example, our IP address, our MAC address, all these things we can change to this thing. Okay. Okay. Now let me give you some example of live attack that I will do. Okay. Sorry for the delay. Okay. Let's start again. Okay. So I was talking about Google Docs. Okay. What are the Google Docs? It will compress the Google search. Okay. So in URL login.asp, what it will give? It will give the login pages which are written in ASP language. Okay, all the URLs and site. Site means .pk if I put. Okay, it will give me all the website of Pakistan. Okay, and it will give the login pages of which country? Of Pakistan. Okay, enter. Okay, yeah, see, it is giving the URLs. See, you can see here, all these are login pages of ASP. Okay, login.asp. Now, what we have to do, let me open this one. Okay, this is a nss.com.pk. Okay, it's some Nayar Sheikh Securities Private Limited. Okay, this is the authentication level, means this is a login page. Login for the web reports, of which type of web report that we can access. User type. User type, I will select here administrator. Okay, then in the user ID, what will we put? One string OR string one string equal to string string one. Okay, what we need, copy this and put it in the same user ID, okay, and the same password. Okay, then what will we give? If the website is vulnerable with this authentication bypass SQL vulnerability, then it will directly drop you to the administration. Okay, see, welcome administrator, and this is a Pakistan website. Okay, nss.com.pk ad panel means admin panel. Okay, message welcome. Okay, now we are into the website. So if we want to do anything, if I want to check this thing, so it will give me the logs. Okay, if I want to check the view all reports. Okay, combine balances and holding. Okay, so they are not, this is giving the report of 6 months. In this last 6 months, there is nothing. This account is a blocked account. Okay, so it means that there will be no records we can find. But in case if you find another websites of this vulnerability, you can get access to the database also. Okay, but the thing is, if the website is not vulnerable with this vulnerability, for example, let me take another website. Okay, it is not opening. Adil Adim Security. It is the same one, I guess. Okay. Okay, this one is also vulnerable. Okay, I'm just going to show you if the website is not vulnerable. Let me open these pages. It is not opening. Okay, distributor ID, I put this one equal to. Okay, see, now I'm entering string one into this. It means that the distributor ID will be of only 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 digits. Okay, it means it will not accept any other except this thing. Okay, it means that if the website is not vulnerable with this vulnerability, so it will directly give you that the website is not the username and password that you are entering into the website, that is not valid. Try and the original one. Okay, and now let me show you some example of this is a very basic example, very basic vulnerability of SQL injection. Okay. Okay, so let me give you some example of social engineering attacks. Okay, social engineering for Facebook. I'm just giving you a demo right now, but if you want a proper, if you go for proper classes, then we will have some more things to do. Okay, so there is a website zshadow.info. Okay, we can just sign up here. You can sign up. Already I had sign up here. Okay. Login into the website. Okay. What is in the website is there are already given some random pages. Okay. Random pages means fake pages of Facebook, for Gmail, Instagram, Twitter. Okay, you can find some pages like that. For example, like this. Okay, what we need, I just go there. This is a page of Facebook Home. Okay, Facebook Home. You can select the language, English, Arabic, Spanish, French. Okay, copy the URL and send it to the victim. Okay, when the victims open this link, it will show him this page. Okay, it will show him this page. So this link is almost 99% is same of the Facebook login page. Okay. Okay, but the thing is, and whenever the victim, for example, I enter this username, and just a second, I enter this username and I enter this password. When I click on login, simply redirect to any website. Okay, but in the main website of Zshadow, when we click on my victims, okay, click on my victims. Okay, you can see here website that I was using, Facebook Home, username I enter this one and password I enter this one. Okay, you can see I had in 18th of April I had given this link to someone else, and she sent me his user, her username and the password also. Okay, but right now this password is changed, so it is not a big deal for me to share with you. Okay, but the thing is, why the person whom you are sending this link will open the URL? Okay, the question is this. The thing that I used is, I just simply sent or tell them that brother, I got some of your pictures that should not be public, but I see all these pictures on Facebook. Okay, the very first question will come to that person's mind, that will be, where did you saw that? Okay, where did you saw that page? Okay, so what it will give you, you just send him this link. Okay, copy the URL from here and then pass it to the victim. So what will be, they will do, they will just open the URL and they will say saw this thing, and whenever the victim enter the username and password, it will directly come to you. Okay, you can also, not only for the Facebook you can do this thing, but for the for other things you can also see, like most of the people play this 8-pool game. You can send him the link of 8-pool. Okay, what we need to do, just enter the username and password, login, and you can enter into the 8-pool game directly. It will give you some coins, it will give you some reward or something like that. Okay, or else if some of the people are fond of creating some followers, okay, just send him these type of links. Okay, add 1000 followers to your account. Okay, add friends if they want friends. Make a page like this. Okay, add over 1000 friends. Okay, same you can use for other things, not for the Facebook only. Okay, for Gmail you can do, Yahoo, YouTube. Okay, and most of the people right now are interested in Instagram. Okay, so you can also use Instagram pages. Okay, what we have to do, we just need to copy the URL from here and send it to the victim. Okay, we just need to do this thing. Okay, But right now, what the thing is, these passwords will be saved only for around 15 days maximum. But the thing is, we can also create our own pages like this. But in that case, we have to be good at in coding. When we are good in coding, that then we can do this thing. Okay, so now let me go for the another part. Okay, let me show you some example of this thing of spam mail spoofing. There is a website, mkai.cz. In this website, what we can do, we can send some fake mails from name, or I will take this example that I use randomly. Now what I'm going to do, from name Shahrukh Khan, from email ID shahrukh@shahrukhkhan.com to my email ID, subject party invitation. So text I can randomly write saying hi Nitish, hope you are doing well. You can type whatever you want. So I'm just randomly going to the point that tomorrow is my birthday, so please come. You can write whatever you want. Please come and send it to the victim. It will take few minutes. Every time it will take few minutes to reach the inbox of the victim. See, the mail is from Shahrukh Khan. Hi Nitesh, hope you're doing well. And you can see here from Shahrukh Khan, shahrukh@shahrukhkhan.com, reply to shahrukh@shahrukhkhan.com to Nitesh Bhatia, date it's today's date, subject is this, and security standard encryption. So we can send these type of emails to your victims. Most of the whenever I go to some workshop of whenever I show this demo in the college students, what they will do, they will send some fake mails to their roommates or to the while some of they one of my students, he sent these type of mails to all the teachers, that from the from email ID that was a vice chancellor email, and they write that my mother got expired yesterday, so the college will be closed for next 2 days. So on that day it was 2 days, or no one was in the college when the vice chancellor came to the college. So we can do something like this, fishy things you can say. One of the most important thing is also there, we can also spoof the calls. So right now it is not working. This is the website name, but I can give you. Spoofcard.com. What we have to write here, there will be two option, destination number. Destination number means in which phone number you are going to call. And the second thing will be display number. For example, destination number is 123456. You will call to this number, but whenever you call to this number, that display number will be this. This is just a random example. For example, destination number is of Sek Army, for example. And the display number will be of mine. So whenever any person called to Sek Army, they can display my number. But the thing is, we just have to purchase some credits, and we will the call will be from not from the Indian server, but it will directly go to the from any random other country's server. We can also call this proxies. Okay. I hope I'm not speaking too fast. Okay. Hope all these topics are clear to you. Okay. So, what is ransomware? That was an attack that is very common right now. Well, not common, but that is very famous right now. Okay. So, what is ransomware? Let me show you a slide of that. Okay. Let me tell you something about phishing before going to this thing. Okay, the thing that the demo of Facebook ID and some other thing that I told you. Okay. Okay, so the thing is, what is phishing? Okay, phishing is an attempt to obtain the sensitive information such as username, password, credit cards. Okay. So what they will do, directly they will talk like this. They will communicate to the person in such a way that all the person can share his or her personal information with that guy. Okay, for if I send a link to that person and I will send a link to those person and tell them to log in, but we have to tell them in such a way that he should okay, so we have to send talk to him in such a way that he should enter into the website. For example, let me give you a live example of this thing. You can say this one. Okay, the mail is from University of Delaware. Okay, but you can say here or see here the email ID from which the mail is coming is ryan came2001@signet.com.sg. okay, if the mail is coming from any university, so they will have their official email ID. Okay, so they will not come to any Signet, any personal organization. Okay, subject will be termination of your edul.edu webmail account. In some of the colleges, they have webmail accounts. Okay, so the student can easily get to know each and everything of the activities of college. Okay, so and the date to, okay, and reply to customer help desk 9@gmail.com. If the mail is coming from university, then why it should reply to any Gmail personal account? Okay, so this mail is almost of convincible that your webmail account is gonna be deactivated. So what they will do, surely they will have to send the details, and what details they are asking for. The subject is termination of your webmail account. We are currently carrying an upgrade to our system, and what are the things that they are asking for this reason? For this reason, all subscribers are to provide the username and password for us to verify and have them clear against the virus. Okay, failure to comply will lead to termination of your account within next 48 hours. Okay, so what they are asking, information to send, email address, username and password. Okay, and sincerely, University of Delaware mail server. Okay, so these are some steps to prevent from the attacks. Okay, learn to identify the suspected phishing emails, check the source of information, never go to your bank website by clicking on links on any of your email IDs, enhance the security of your computer, because we can just increase the security. We can't just completely secure our systems. Okay, enter your sensitive data in secure websites only, periodically check your accounts. Phishing doesn't only pertain to online banking. Okay, and the most important thing, change your passwords in a regular way. Okay, why? In security, in hacking, we have a common proverb, you can say, like change your password like you change your underwear daily. Okay, so it will increase the security of your accounts. Okay, whatever it may be, your Facebook account, your Gmail account, or any bank account. Okay, you just randomly change your passwords in a weekly or in a 10 days or in a 2 weeks, but change them in a regular way. Okay. So the next thing is how we can protect ourselves from our system. We can the common thing is that I came to know from many of my students that they say this thing: stop using internet. But the thing is, can we stop using internet? Okay, if we don't use the internet, then what it will give, we cannot be affected by any attack. Okay. But the thing is, if we attack on the website, there is a database, okay, we will get the access to the database. But in our system, also there is a database, our personal database. Okay, so the thing, what will you have to do with there? for example, let me give you a simple example of a forensics person. They find a laptop or a system that is password protected in a crime location. Okay, there was some murder or any crime and they found a laptop. Okay, for example, what they will do, the password is the system will be password protected. Okay, then what it will do, they have to bypass the password, or we have to change the password. We can also reset the password. Okay, we can do all these things in this thing. Okay, in forensics, I will also, if you're gonna do the classes, okay, then you can then you will came to know how to do that thing also. Okay, now let me show you the course module. Okay, okay, these questions and these topics, this module will be covered in the classes. Okay, firstly we will start with the networking basics. What is IP address, what are ports, okay, and okay, some basics of Linux, how to create a virtual lab. Okay, virtual lab means sometimes we have to use multiple operating system in a single time. So what will we do? We will create a virtual lab in our system only. Okay, so we can use our Windows and our Linux system as well in a single time. Okay, installation of Linux and how to use Linux also. Okay, what is cyber security and what is the scope of cyber security in future? Introduction to hacking, ethical hacking. Some of the topics are clear today, but some more are to go. Okay, then information gathering, that I told you the most important part of hacking, information gathering, in which we will gather some normal information, some email information, DNS information, and Google hacking database also. Scanning part, we will scan the ports, we will scan the network, we will scan the website to find the vulnerabilities so that we can directly and easily attack on the website. Okay, and enumeration, in enumeration we will find the hidden information about the website, like if the admin page of the website is hidden, we can also find from that thing. Okay. system hacking and security. Okay, password breaking of Windows with Wondershare Live USB means we will reset the password of the system. We will enter into the password without the user, without knowing the old password. Okay, and also we will reset the password so that it will not ask for any password. Okay, and steganography. Steganography means hiding the data behind the data. We will hide our database behind the other database. For example, like we will hide our text to image behind the picture image. Okay. Malware threats, virus, worms, trojans. We will create our own virus trojan. Using those, we will attack into the system. We can access the system remotely. Okay. Windows hacking using payloads. We will create a payload. In that, we can also use the system remotely. We can get all the information about the database. And more of the things, VPN proxies, okay, forward network trafficking means we will forward all the network traffic to a single single person, okay. Then VPN proxies and Tor browser, okay. Sniffing password means MITM attack, man in the middle attack. It means that if anyone enters any password into the same network, firstly it will come to you, and then it will go to the router, okay. And then DDoS attack, we will attack on a particular system, okay, a particular system or in a particular network. We can attack on a particular website, we can attack, so the website will be slowed down. The same very simple example of this thing is whenever the results of any school or any college came, what it will ask for. Sometime it is the website is slowed down. Why? The question is why? Because most of the students are on the website. Okay, if there are, for example, there are 100 students and they are looking for the results, 95% of the students will come to that website and they will check their results. So the traffic of the bandwidth of the website will be covered, and all the space will be covered by those users, and so the website will be slowed down. Okay, we can do that thing in a single system, then it is called DOS. If we do it with the multiple system, then it is called DDoS. DOS means denial of service, DDoS means distributed denial of service. Okay, then we'll do some fake social engineering attacks. Fake mail, phishing page for FB and Gmail that I told you about right now, call spoofing and SMS bombing. Okay, call spoofing means we can call to anyone from anyone's number. If the person, if you want to call to your girlfriend or your boyfriend from any other number, you can also do that thing. Okay, SMS bombing, we can randomly send any website, any messages to any number. If you want to send 100 messages to someone, we can do that also. If you want to send 1000 SMS, we can also send that. Okay. Then SQL injection, first one, authentication bypass that I told you right now. Unit-based SQL injection, string-based SQL injection, and SQL map. Okay, these four different type of SQL injection that we'll do in the practical session. Web application attacks, LFI, RFI, DNN, XSS attack. We'll also do this for website hacking. Then Wi-Fi hacking, okay. Then the security parts come, because if you are attacking on a system, then someone also can attack on your device. Okay, for that thing, we will give the security to the person. Or else, if you're working in a company and there are more than 50 systems and you have to give security to all the systems, so what will you do? Okay, using NIDS, IPS, IDS. IDS means intrusion detection system, IPS means intrusion prevention system. NIDS means network intrusion detection system. Means if anyone is attacking on your system, we can block that IP address, we can forward the data packets, we can do further things also. Okay, using the IP tables, we can do that thing. And using the IP tables, we can also manage the traffic on the website also. Okay, Android hacking, we can also hack into Android phone. Okay, and the last one will be the introduction to ransomware. And it's working. The most common that we came to know, that was the WannaCry. Okay, WannaCry attack into almost of the 30% of the world, and in India most of the police systems were also corrupted with this virus. Ransomware. Okay, it will encrypt all the files, all the database of that system. Okay, so these topics we will clear on the in the course module, and the timings and the course details, I will show you that also. Okay. just a bit. Okay, in this link you can see that module also. Okay, and duration will be 30 days training. Okay, 1 hour per day. There will be 5 batches each day following timings. Okay, morning we have 3 batches, 8 a.m. to 9 a.m., then 9:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m., 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. Okay, and in the afternoon 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. and 3:30 to 4:30. Okay, and the duration will be of 30 days, means from Monday to Friday. We have these batches right now, and all the other details you can email us or you can call us for the other details, like how you will pay the fee and all the other things. Also, in this fee, that will be around, most probably there will be minimum fee for this thing, and I will give you all the database, or will give you all the tools, all the operating systems that we will use. Okay, and all the study material that you will use, and also the some 100 plus videos of hacking that I will provide you. Okay, this is the training module that I shown you. You can also see here in our website of sec.army. okay, about the trainer, this is my profile, Nitesh Bhatia from CHFI. These are some I had done, and the fee charges are only 2000. Okay, in 2000 rupees INR. Okay, if that, if international students are there, that is only around 30 USD. okay, in 30 USD you will get a 1 month training, and this this coming soon. Okay, the payments will be start from maximum 1st of the May, means next month of the 1st May you can start your registration. Okay, you can pay directly from here. Okay, and let me show you what you will get. Okay, in 2000, okay, fee 2000. Okay, training of almost a month. Okay, 30 days. Okay, all study material. Okay, 500 plus PDF I will give you from my side. Okay, 100 plus videos. Okay, these videos will be of hacking videos. Okay, and also you can ask me if you have any question, if you have any doubt, you can ask me anytime. Okay, so let's start the Q&A session. Okay, okay, let's come to the question answer. Okay, how to download this video. Okay, how to be a bug hunter professional. Okay, so the thing is, the question by the human error. Okay, your error. Okay, so okay, so the thing is, if you want to be a professional, we have to, every time we have to start from the very beginning, and only the practice can make you a professional. Okay, like you can go starting, you can do with this course. Okay, after this course you can go for the bug hunting classes. Okay, anonymous Randy, what is CVV? CVV is the POC. okay, POC means the proof of concept that are the already which are presented on the bug crowd, or okay, in bug crowd or hacker one, you can say, you can find many more question, many more things there. Okay, is dual booting PC with Windows and Linux code, which is better, Kali or Parrot? Okay, okay, Parrot, Kali is better than Parrot, because the thing is, more tools are there in Parrot. Oh, sorry, in Kali Linux. And Tushar, can you please share the presentation? Sorry, Tushar, I can't share the presentation right now. Okay, what is the duration for the seminar? The seminar, it is done today. Okay, it was not a seminar, it was, that is called a webinar. Okay, so if you have, if you want to attend any classes, okay, so you can start from this thing. Sir, can you please tell me which is the best laptop under 50k middle class boy can afford the hacking afford for hacking? Please mention the names. I don't think this is a silly question. I'm really confused. Please, sir. Okay. 50K is a good amount. You can get a very good laptop. Okay. Just a second. Okay, I guess these are the recent questions. Okay, let me start from the beginning. Okay. Just a second. I'm a little confused right now. The questions are coming from here. Okay. IdeaPad. Okay, you can get that laptop where I can download this video. Note a so-called pattern for submitting bug bounty. Okay, if you can suggest me a very big web better than this pattern, you can send me that also. Seriously, but okay, let it be then. If you are that much of lead, then you should not be here. Okay, you can start your webinars and seminars also. Common vulnerability security system, it is a basic score for your bug bounting. Okay, duration of webinar. Are you on Telegram? Free Gamer, which is the best laptop for hacking and programming under 35,000 laptop. You can search it on Google, bro. Okay, how can a website is compromised? In scanning, we will find get to know this thing. Okay. In scanning, what we'll find the vulnerability video stop is stuck. Sorry for that thing. Okay. I'm a winner. I want to learn ethical hacking. Okay, how come it will check the strings like equal to zero? You can check it, bro. And if you want some more things in this SQL injection, I will tell you in the classes part. Don't worry about that thing. Injection do you use? I don't know at which topic you are talking about. How to remain undetectable while performing SQL injection? We can use proxies and Tor browser in that we can be anonymous, but it will be a huge part of that that I cannot tell you right now, because we are running out of time right now. So I can I watch this video after webinar? I don't know. It depends upon you. Which is the best VPN I can use? Best VPN is CyberGhost. You can use that. Okay. Which one is better to learn hacking? Vulnerability, HTTP, Rootme. Okay. You can, if you want to learn hacking, then you can start the classes. And for bug bounty program and bug hunting, you can find some more things. Okay, will the training will be live on every day as per the batch timing, and what if we miss someday? If you miss someday, it in the last 5 days, okay, 3 to 5 days, we will have some we will have a question answer session right now that we are doing right now. Okay, in that part you can ask me the question if that time. Okay, and the timing will be the batch that will be same that are mentioned in the website. Okay, which qualification is required to become a professional hacker? Okay, you want to be a professional hacker? I don't think so. Okay, how to trace any Facebook messages? Is it a webinar? Is it a webinar? How to join in army in the business of cyber security and hacking? How to use a RAT while not in their Wi-Fi connection? Okay, if you are not in the same Wi-Fi connection, then we have to do port forwarding. Okay, you can use a ngrok tool for that. Create your own RAT or any Trojan using the ngrok so that you can also forward the port also. How to trace the phone calls? If you need to learn it urgently, just directly go to your nearest police station, lodge an FIR against the person. Okay, and they will trace that, because these tools are just given to the army and to the government and to the police only. We are not we can say we are not we can't access these things. Okay, what about the story you guys posted on Insta to have such seminars randomly in coming weeks? I don't know. Is Linux recommended? Yes, we recommend this thing. What can we do? Find this memory. What can we do if we find? You can't do anything, because someone else is also doing this thing. Link to join Check Army. You can just follow us on Facebook, Instagram. use. Okay, what can be further space? I want to know that the difference between again and cyber security. Anonymous identity, you have a lot of question, I guess. You can call to that number and surely we will reply you. How to be a violent hacker in a cyber commando? You should add subtitle for death people. Okay, it should be. It's not death, I guess. It should be deaf. Okay. Is that the domain of, yes, it is a domain of cybersecurity. Can a BC student know? I guess anonymous identity, you cannot do anything. I guess, bro, you need to explain about disclosure terms and conditions need to be checked. Let it be. I'm just going to ignore you, okay? What will you do to find the Pakistan website you had? That was authentication bypass vulnerability. Sonia, how to report a bug? Google the necessary account in a blockchain? No. Blockchain is a different thing. Okay, the blockchain. Is it ethical hacking? Oh, he's gonna teach those classes and it is. Is it free? No, I will teach you this thing and the fee will be around 2000 rupees per month. Not per month, it will be of 1 month training and the fee will be 2000 only. Fake mail can't work. Okay, Tanuj, it is. If it is not working, I will give you some more tools, more website for this thing. And also, you can make your own scripts for this. No honeyports. Please enable chat. I can't chat right now. What is the fee? Fee is 2000 only. Is it a live seminar? You can see. What is it? But the prerequisite, you should. I will tell you when you, whenever you want to start the classes, I will tell you that. So timings are not cool. It depends upon you, brother. Because these are our timings, and we have some other works to do also. To be able to enroll in this course, okay, Ganesh, you are welcome. Is this sufficient for CEH? After this course, I will also help you for the CEH. I will give you some guidance, and also if you need anything else, I will also provide you that. Is it a live seminar? Can I access the study material after? Yes, yes, you can access this thing also. I will give you it. I will send the Google Drive link so you can enter. You can download anytime, and you can keep it with you. In order to train individual penetration testing also. Yes, I will teach you. Is it a live seminar? Can I access? How do I get anonymous over the net without paying anything? Talk something about hiding while the proving any attacks. Then I know some basic on networking. How does call spoofing work? Call spoofing, it will just. Can you share the PPT, Nitesh? No, I can't share you, Nitesh. Not for right now. How can I prepare for OSCP? You can contact, we'll give you the training. There are exam in May, June, because we're after the June. Okay, no problem. I'm just ignoring you, no issue. So you can live testing on website. Yes, we'll do. But the cyber crime ecosystem management, it is another course series also. It is a management level. Okay, we just have to manage how enable this thing. Okay, hi Nitesh, good evening. I want to ask you that for CHFI certification, is OSCP or CH is required? For CHFI, nothing is required. Okay, and if you want to do this course or if you want to do any certification, you can also contact me or any other person from the SEC Army. Okay, that is not a big deal. We'll also help you in that. Can I get the website which is giving the for was moving so a call? I will give you. Okay. Anonymous, I'm just ignoring you right now. Can you change the time of time one of the year batch because some students have college till 5 or 6 p.m. Okay, we can look after that. If there are more than 10 students or if there are 15, then we can make it to 5 or 6. Okay, we can also make it after 6 o'clock. Okay, but the only thing is there should be more than 10 to, there should be 10 to 15 students. Okay, from where we will be, where you have been certified. I had done around 7 or 8 certification from EC Council and some other companies. From where did you certify? Can you share the PPT? Not right now. How can I go for OSCP? As I'm good in CTFs. Okay. See, OSCP and CTF is a very different thing, brother. Okay, in CTI we just have to challenge. Okay, but in OSCP there will be an exam of around 24 hours. You will be given around 5 machines and you have to crack minimum of 3 machines. Okay, is there any possibility of CH for free from EC Council? Yeah, you can just hack into the EC Council website and you can get the free CH voucher. But I am 200% sure still that you will not able to pass the exam. Best of luck for you, brother. But if you want the certification, you can contact us. We'll provide you that thing. Okay, is it a webinar? How to create a data payload? Future of BCMCA in India? How you train in videos or a live platform? Yeah, it will be a live platform like this only. Windows to use the inspector tool. The videos you will providing will be not my personal videos, that will be of some other trainers and some other things that you can say that will be like CBT nuggets. We are getting only one lecture free, of course, because the famous Joker, if you remember in Batman movie, he said, if you are good at something, never do it for free. Okay, but still we are providing this lecture to you free of cost. Where will be the class of your course, sir? Okay, we'll provide you after this thing. Okay, whenever you register, after that we'll provide you this thing. Book list, that will be the official PDFs from EC Council that I will give you. Can we get this seminar video? I don't know, depends upon you. How to enter in database or website? I will tell you whenever we attack on the website and whenever you install into the when you register into the course. Will I be in touch with teachers for any further doubts? Even after this year? Yeah, for doubts we can clear, but we can't repeat the complete lecture. Okay, any certificate will be given for the course. Yeah, we will give you the training certification. We can give you. Okay, training certificate will come to your mail. You can print it out. Okay. Please help me to join to your army. Future of BCA in India, because you're teaching in the beginning. Yeah, I will teach you from the beginning. Okay, we will start from what is hacking and basics of hacking. Then we'll go to the tail end of ransomware. Okay, when does the course start? Might be on 13th of May. After 15 days from now, we'll start the course. You said 5 batches not suitable for me, so can you add me? Yeah, we can add you after 6:30, but there should be minimum of 10 students. Would CH be enough to become a bug hunter? It depends upon the knowledge. Knowledge is most important, not the CH. What are the prerequisites for enrolling in this course? Whenever you enroll, we'll also give you the prerequisite. I will give you each and everything. Don't worry about anything. But it's max spoofing. I ignore you, bro. How to find the original IP? Someone use VPN. Yeah, using if someone is tracking using the logs into the website, we can get the original IP address also. Okay, I'm just running out of time, so that's why I'm just ignoring some messages. If you have some other things also, you can ping me after this thing. EC Council is best. Yeah, EC Council is one of the most reputed company. If you want to go for the certification, you can go from there. And if you want certification, I will also provide you. But the thing is, EC Council is providing in $950. That is almost around 70,000 Indian rupees. Okay, if you contact us, we'll provide you less cost. When the course will start, it will be most probably it will start from 13th of May. Sir, my exam start from 3rd May. I will start until 21st May onward. Please reply me. You can start in the next month. We will have another batch. Okay. Will I be in touch with teacher for any further doubts even after 30 days? Yes, you can be. Hello world. Okay. Timings are not good. Okay. So what do we also tell? Become a professional hacker. Even I have 9th class students who are doing a very good job. Sometimes due to fluctuation in PC, my PhD document got corrupted many times. Which is pretty cyber ecosystem. About ICE, I use it in for kinetics too. When I'm fed up with manual testing, it got nothing. Very good. Even I'm using the same, brother, 10.5. West VPN, which is free. You can use just proxies, brother. Book list, bro. Which is the best tool for DDoS attack. Okay, the business is converted CCNA. Should I do CH? Yeah, that is the best thing for you right now. Ramakrishna, how to bypass the survey available for downloads. I guess, bro, you forgot to tell people to check always for scope for reporting to save having the subs. If they are good enough in attack, so they are good enough to handle the pros and cons of the attacks also. Okay, how many hours you teach? 1 hour per day. This should bro is the freak you talk about the higher level. Just go. I'm just ignoring you, bro. How to meet a red and detectable, but there are some cryptos and is it safe to hack a function website with you? What IMS Noida file doing there? Let me just ignore you also. It's just none of your concern, brother. We can do internship on this field. Can you help me? Yeah, you can contact us. Even having a triple node encryption, how you told brother using trace, how much time have we take to update holoc list? Okay. Okay, now I'm just sitting there, so I asked. Okay, no problem. Actually, I had given two workshops in IMS Noida. Okay, so that's why that folder was of that thing. I had given two workshops, the first one on ethical hacking, and the second one was of Python. That's why the file is there. Can you start a new batch after 5 or 6? I have 5 friends interested. Okay, yeah, we can start if we have around 10 students, because most of the person are saying this thing, so we can start a batch at that time also. That is not a big deal. Okay, can you show the things searching vulnerabilities on Google Docs with the scope of ethical hacking? Just Google it, brother, you will get to know. Let me just shut your mouth right now. Okay, you are asking for the scope. Okay, just let me show you a single thing, okay, of cyber security. I'm just saying, okay, so you can see here, what is this field? Information security, current demand high, and USD 1 lakh USD per year. Okay, you can get clear this thing, how to get into government organization for testing or for attacking, you want to ask. Okay, I guess we are done now. Okay, so guys, if you have any further questions or anything else, you can chat in 5chat. 530 questions are there. Okay, let me just go through this. This is spam for bug bounty. Okay, I'm an engineer. Test sound working, guys. Okay, what is, because everything is vulnerable. Okay guys, we are about to done now. Okay, if you have anything else, okay, you can contact us. Okay, so our timing is done now. Let's catch you on 13th of the May or next Sunday also. Okay, see you guys. Have a nice evening.